Hi guys, you're watching Halborn Flash videos and our guest of the hour is Crypwalk from Y2K. So Crypwalk, first of all, very, very welcome to talking to us on this chat. How about you tell us a little bit about yourself, where you're coming from and your scope of work with Y2K in general?
Yeah, first of all, thank you guys for having me on. And yeah, my background is before DeFi, I had a background in micro and macroeconomic research. Was doing it full time at a research facility in France, and got into DeFi full time about a year ago, where I was a full time contributor at Redacted, and then also a fundamental research analyst at New Order, where we did a lot of the research for this project. And at this point, I'm going to be the founder and business lead of Y2K, and from a day-to-day standpoint, I'm involved in the internal policy side and the partnerships and business development side there as well.
Awesome. All right, that's a great journey and thanks for sharing that with us. Tell us a little bit about what is Y2K all about?
Yeah, so the way we see Y2K is a novel method of gaining exposure to the strength and the underlying risk or strength of different pegged assets. So you can think of pegged assets like stable coins, obviously, that are pegged to the US dollar, or any other kind of pegged asset that gives you that intrinsically gives you a one-to-one return for the asset that you deposit with the asset that you get back. So like STETH, for example, you stake ETH, and STETH is supposed to represent a one-to-one kind of pairing for ETH. And we allow people to get exposure to the strength of those pegs, in a fully collateralized and decentralized manner.
All right, awesome. And I just took a quick look at your profile on Y2K, and I saw that you guys have a very cool suite of products, so Earthquake, Tsunami, and Wildfire. Tell us a bit about that product suite and what you have in line on the next milestones as well.
Yeah, for sure. So Tsunami is more in the R&D phase, and that'll be more of our take on money markets on Arbitrum. We should be putting more information out very soon. But in terms of what we'll have on offering during launch, it'll be our Earthquake and our Wildfire product. And just a quick word on Earthquake. Earthquake is our two-sided insurance vaults, if you want to call them, where users can either deposit ETH as premium to take out a hedge against a particular stablecoin or pegged asset depegging, and also deposit ETH as collateral on the other side to underwrite risk for a specific pegged asset or stablecoin depegging. And the way those vaults work is simply when users deposit ETH as collateral, they have a right to the premium on the other side of the vault. In case there's no depegging event throughout the epoch, and if there is a depegging event, their collateral is liquidated over to the premium depositors, but they still will collect that premium. And for the premium depositors, when they deposit premium inside of the premium vaults, they have a right to the collateral if there is a depegging event in the vaults. And each vault has two strike prices, a high strike price, which is more of a weekly vault, and then a lower strike price, which is more of a monthly vault. And for any side that claims a reward at the end of the epochs, whether it be the week-long epoch or the month-long epoch, the protocol collects a 5% fee, 30% of which goes to our treasury, and 70% which goes to our VEY2K lockers. And while your funds are locked up for either a week or a month, our Wildfire product is a secondary marketplace where you can trade in and out of your positions. When you do deposit ETH into those Earthquake vaults, you mint out an ERC-1155 token, which are semi-fungible tokens. And you're able to trade in and out of those tokens on Wildfire, or if you haven't been able to deposit into the vaults before the epoch started, you can also come in and take on one of these positions through the secondary market, which is Wildfire as well. And on the Wildfire product, and on the exchange, we would be taking a 0.25% transaction fee, which is the same kind of revenue split, 70% of that going to VUY2K lockers, and 30% of that going back to our treasury.
Right, very interesting. It's quite cool to see how your different products are kind of tackling different aspects of the whole spectrum in general. I know that at Halborn, we recently audited the Earthquake core smart contracts. Do you want to talk a little bit about the auditing experience and the cybersecurity partnership that we did with that?
Yeah, for sure. So if I'm not mistaken, we've got three rounds of audits through you guys. And from a user experience standpoint, from our end, it was pretty smooth. You guys were very responsive, and any kind of issues or questions we had with kind of the comments you made, we also got a pretty quick response. And we felt like our engineers felt like you guys did do a pretty thorough job. And from a high level, we were pretty kind of satisfied with the experience, I would say, from a user experience standpoint.
Right. And when you especially look back at your own build journey, at what point did cybersecurity become like a top priority or a concern? And how does your team in general approach that?
Yeah, absolutely. And kind of, I would say the minute we started putting the smart contracts together and realized, one, that we'd be asking people to lock up their funds, and two, that the whole point of our like protocol is to make sure that people do have a hedge against their positions in other parts of the DeFi ecosystem. And you know, if a depegging event were to happen, you want these funds to be available, or kind of there's no use case for our product. So we knew that security would be like the utmost priority, which is why kind of we wanted to get our codes audited by industry leaders like you guys, and also kind of get audits after that, right? Just to make sure we've got second and third opinions. And we've also went through the lengths of even hiring devs with past auditing experience, just to make sure that we're fully buttoned up on the security end. Because as I stated before, when you do have users locking up funds on your protocol and your contracts, it is up to you to make sure that they are available for those users when they need them.
Now that's pretty awesome looking at how you guys view security for us. It's always like the top priority, and we have been working hard at making sure that it's not an afterthought. So that's great to hear, absolutely. Crypwalk, thank you so much for sharing all these details about Y2K. We learned a lot from here. And yeah, if I could end this conversation with just one more fun question, which is, if you could possibly look back at your own journey thus far with Y2K, and maybe is there something that stands out as, I wish I knew that at that point in time rather than now?
Yeah, honestly, it's two things. It's one that, you know, when you're building these kind of things and just in the space in general, things move very fast, right? Like weeks are almost like months, months are almost like years. So you just have to be very adaptable and very, you just have to know that the plan is always going to change, and that's just, that's okay. Nothing wrong with it. Just kind of, you know, part of the journey. And also like a pretty good advice that I got right at the beginning is anything that you think of building out there, just double the time and double the cost, because that'll probably give you a better estimate of kind of what you're undertaking there.
Yeah, that's a very interesting take on that. Thank you again for sharing that as well. And thanks for joining us in again. And to our viewers, if you have a question about Y2K AMA, feel free to comment and let us know, and we'll get back to you very soon. Thanks so much.